Hi, in this lesson, we will explore what happens behind the scene when we run our program. And the entire program execution flow which you are going to see in this lesson is applicable for both C and C++ programs. Well, we already know that how a compiler converts our source code into an executable format which is understandable by the computer. And this executable format is generally in the binary form, such as a sequence of 0 and 1. But apart from the compiler, there are a lot of tools that are involved in the execution of the program. So, here we go. This is the complete execution flow, starting from the source code over here, and in the end, our program gets running. So, let's talk about this flow, how it actually works behind the scene. So, in the beginning, we have our source code, that is our program. Now, when we run our program, the first tool to which our source code is passed is known as preprocessor. Then it is passed to the compiler, then to a tool known as assembler, then to linker, and finally to a tool known as loader, which loads our program into the memory and our program starts to run in the output console. Fine. Now let's assume our source file name is either myfile.c or myfile.cpp. And let us assume this is our program. So this is a sample program to find out the area of a circle. And this is a C++ program. You can have the C program in place of this as well. So this lesson is applicable for both C and C++. So don't get confused over here. This is just a sample. So once your program is ready, it is then sent to the tool known as preprocessor. And this tool, what it does, it first removes all the comments present in our program and expands all the preprocessor directives such as macros or file inclusions. So the preprocessor removes this comment and this comment over here, like this, and expand the preprocessor directives. For example, here we have a macro preprocessor directive. So this hash define statement will be removed and this pi over here will be replaced by 3.14. That is the actual value, like this. Fine. Then we also have this file inclusion preprocessor directive. Well, this statement will be replaced by the content of this header file iostream. Which means, in place of this statement, we will get the entire code present in that file in our current program. Let us assume this portion represents the actual code present in that header file. So once our program passes through the preprocessor, our file will no longer have .c or .c++ file extension. It will become myfile.i. So please note this. So after preprocessor, the file that we will get is myfile.i. And the content of this file will be known as the expanded source code or simply expanded code. So please again note this. And this expanded code is then sent to the compiler for further processing. So the compiler basically checks for possible syntax errors or any error that violates the rule of writing a C or C++ program. And if there is an error, then the execution will stop then and there. And if there is no error found, then the expanded code will be converted into an assembly code. So right after compiler, we get assembly code. And the output file will become myfile.s. Now please note that the file extension is now .s. Fine. So this assembly code is then sent to another tool known as assembler. So what is the role of assembler over here? Well, the assembler converts the assembly code into object code. And this object code is actually understandable by our computer. Well, this object code is also known as bytecode or binary code or the machine level code, which is actually represented by 0 or 1 number digits. So after assembler, we get a new file that will contain the object code. Now, if you're on Windows, then the file name will be myfile.obj. And if you are on Linux or Mac, then the file name will be myfile.o. So this is something which you need to remember. Pretty awesome. Now moving on, this object code is then passed to another tool known as linker. Well, linker basically converts the object code into executable code, which is our executable file. So after linker, we get a file with .exe file extension, which contains our executable code. Then finally, in the end, another tool known as loader loads the executable file into memory and executes it. So after execution, it is then sent to the output console, where our program starts to run. So yes, this is the complete flow of execution of the program. So I hope you understand how a program execution takes place behind the scene. Also, before I end this lesson, I would like to point out something. If you open to see the file content of assembly code, object code, and executable code, then you won't be able to understand anything. The content of these files is only understandable by computers or some special software. This means as a programmer, we can only understand the file content until this expanded code. So please again note this. So yes, that's all for this lesson. Thank you and have a nice day.